Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to present Man Not Caring.
What's up guys, Sal here. So let's cut right to the chase. Someone fooled the Galaxy S10's ultrasonic fingerprint scanner. A researcher going by the name Dark Shark did an experiment where he took an image of his fingerprint from a wine glass and then used Photoshop to create a mask of his fingerprint. Then he made a 3D model of his fingerprint using that mask and finally 3D printed his fingerprint on a piece of glass. And as you can see, with this technique, he's able to unlock his Galaxy S10 Plus. First of all, kudos to this guy for going through all of that hassle to educate us in understanding where these biometric scanners stand in terms of security. Second of all, should you even care? You should know by this point that biometric security options on a smartphone are not very secure. They can easily be fooled, doesn't matter if it's the ultrasonic scanner or the Face ID from Apple, they all have their limitations. We've seen Face ID being tricked with a 3D mask, a kid unlocking his mom's phone and more. There have been a lot of instances. The same goes to the ultrasonic scanner or the traditional capacitive scanner that you find on devices like the Galaxy S9, Note 9 or most of the Android devices. In fact, here's a video from Michigan State University demonstrating how easy it is to trick the capacitive scanner as well. So, fooling a fingerprint scanner or any biometric option is not a new thing. They all have their limitations. So, should you stop using the fingerprint scanner? No, that would be really dumb. Listen, there's always going to be a trade-off between convenience and security. Fingerprint scanners are a matter of convenience, which is secure enough to 99.9% of the people. If you really want a top-notch protection, then use a 10-digit password. But again, everyone knows it's not convenient to input a 10-digit password every time you unlock your phone. So people choose a secure enough biometric unlocking tool. If you're not a celebrity, if you're not a president of a country, or a very important person in general, then you have absolutely nothing to worry about. No one's gonna go through all of that hassle to break into your phone. The probability of that happening is none, I would say. Anyway, let me know what you think. Are you really surprised that a 3D replica of a fingerprint was able to unlock that person's phone? Let me know in the comments, and I'll see you all tomorrow. Peace out.